No matter where you go in the country, docks are known to hold bass. And I'm just gonna go over a handful of the techniques that I prefer to target docks throughout the country. And I'm gonna kinda go over my key, probably 2-3 real confidence baits, and then a couple others to throw in there that are somewhat situational. The absolute number one for me is gonna be a jig. This is just a 3/8 ounce flipping and pitching jig. It comes through wood, grass, docks, anything really well. You know, you're not having to put on a new plastic all the time. You can cover a lot of water, and generally it's gonna get you a pretty big bite, or at least give you the opportunity for a big bite. So a jig would be my absolute number one first choice. What I like in a good dock jig is the ability to skip it. A couple things allow you to do that. A flat trailer, this is just a standard beaver style trailer, 3-inch, 3.5-inch. And then a jig head that's somewhat got a flat bottom to it. This one from All Terrain has a little bit of a flat bottom to it. And lastly, you want a pretty stout hook. You're using 17 to 20 pound fluorocarbon. So you want a good hook on there, not a finesse style hook. Those are kind of the three things to me that make a good dock jig. So when I'm fishing a jig around docks, I like a little bit shorter rod. This is a 7-foot heavy action from St. Croix. It's actually their dock sniper rod. That little shorter rod allows me to be more accurate with my casts. I can skip a lot easier with it. And then I'm typically using 17 to 20 pound Suffix advanced fluorocarbon on this jig rod, and then also my Texas rig rod, which is actually kind of my number two go-to for dock fishing. This is just a Texas rig soft plastic. I think this is a 3/16 ounce weight. It's pegged. That allows you to skip it a little bit better than if you didn't have it pegged. I like this in situations where maybe those docks are getting a little bit more pressure. It's a little bit smaller, slender profile, a little bit different than a jig. I don't think they see a lot of beaver style baits around docks. So that's number two for me. This is a 7-foot medium heavy action rod. Once again, 7-foot shorter, allows me to be more accurate. And I kind of like that medium heavy for these lighter Texas rigs. So something kind of similar to the jig, but a little bit different. Once again, 17 to 20 pound Suffix advanced fluorocarbon on that setup. On this Texas rig beaver that I've got here, this is a 4-aught VMC heavy duty flipping hook. It's their straight shank. And then 3/16 ounce VMC tungsten weight to this bobber stop here. That bobber stop just allows you to skip it easier. I like having a free weight when I'm fishing offshore, but I really like that bobber stop whenever I'm around cover, wood, docks, shallow grass, that sort of thing. But that's my setup for the Texas rig. It gives you a little bit different look than a jig. A little bit more gliding action with that beaver, maybe a little bit more of a bluegill imitation. Next up is a wacky rig. You know, it's super easy to skip. You know, you can get it in places that maybe you can't always get a jig. It kind of hovers, it flutters there. I think everyone knows the power of a wacky rig, but they're super effective around docks. Also works really well on some really deep docks where those fish are suspended. You know, whether it's spotted bass, you know, down south under those floating docks, this wacky rig can be really deadly there too. So, and this is actually a number two Nico hook. This Nico hook's become super popular in the last several years. It seems like once you hook up with those fish, you've pretty much got them pegged. It's, you know, my landing ratio is, you know, 95% or more with this hook, it seems like. And then to attach it to the worm, this is just a 5-inch stick worm. I've used the new VMC crossover band, which is pretty cool. You can Nico rig it or you can wacky rig it with that crossover band. It seems like I lose way less worms with that thing, and it gives it a nice natural approach. Especially when you're wacky rigging it, one other thing that's cool is your hook is not buried in that plastic. So you get a little bit bigger bite with that hook and that crossover band compared to if you were just to hook it straight through the plastic. And that crossover band, I don't know if you can see it, it's a little bit wider than your standard O-ring. And so it's gonna cover a little bit more surface area on that worm, and in turn, it's not gonna tear your worm nearly as easily as your thin O-rings that we've used in the past. So it's a really good solution for wacky rigging and Nico rigging. It's something that I've used a lot this summer with a lot of success. I'm throwing it on 10 pound Suffix 131 braid to a 10 pound Suffix advanced fluorocarbon leader. And this is a little bit shorter spinning rod. It's a 6'8" medium extra fast. It's got a real fast tip to it, which enables you to skip. And then it's a little bit shorter, which I kind of like around docks with spinning rods. Instead of using a 7.76 spinning rod, I can just be a little bit more accurate with it. And then just the Daiwa Tatula 3000 size spinning reel. So those are my top three dock fishing baits. They're a little bit slower moving, a little more methodical, but if I had to go anywhere in the country, those would be my top three first choices. These next two that I'm going to go over, you can cover a little bit more water with them, a little bit more of a reaction bite than these first three, but they also can be super effective at times. This first one is just a bladed jig. You can throw this thing around shallow, mid-depth, deep docks. They'll suspend under them. You can get them to react to this thing. Whether it's green pumpkin and you're trying to imitate a bluegill or perch, or white and you're imitating more of your shad or minnow-based forages, you know, a bladed jig is super effective all across the country, and it's no different when it comes to throwing one around a dock. And my setup for that, I throw a 7.2 heavy power moderate action. It's the St. Croix Mojo glass with a 7-to-1 Daiwa Tatula Elite. And then I usually throw this on either 14, 17, or 20 pound Suffix advanced fluorocarbon, depending on what cover I'm fishing around. Super effective. You can cover a ton of water and generally get a reaction bite with this type of bait. And if you get into an area and you're discovering that you're catching fish on this thing, you can sometimes double back with that jig, wacky worm, or the Texas rig and pick up a few more. But if you're just looking to cover ground, this bladed jig can get you a lot of bites. So one cool part about the bladed jig is it's not really a reaction bait that you can only throw on the outside of docks. Like a spinner bait or a crank bait, a lot of times you're limited to throwing around the edges. With this bladed jig, you can skip this thing pretty much anywhere you want to. So you can cover the entire dock very, very effectively. It's a fast moving bait, it's a reaction bait. So you can cover a ton of ground with it. If you're on a lake that is absolutely full of docks and you're trying to eliminate water and discover which ones are holding active fish, this is a really good bait to do that with. You can cover a lot of ground. You can put your trolling motor on that medium to high setting and just go and really determine those better stretches. And then if you want to go back over what you found to be the better stretches with a jig, Texas rig, or wacky worm, you can certainly do that. But to help eliminate water and get a reaction strike and cover ground, this is a great bait to do that with. And lastly is a frog, and this might be a bait that not a lot of guys are using. I don't think bass see frogs around docks a whole lot. The times when I'm using this can be somewhat specific. You know, if you're seeing that bait up in the water column, whether it's shad or bluegill, and those fish are feeding up, can be a really good time to try this frog. I generally like sunnier conditions when I'm throwing this around docks because you're fishing shade lines. Occasionally you can get bit on this thing when it's cloudy around docks, but I really like it when those shade lines are present and that bait is sitting up. It's another one of those baits you can kind of cover the whole thing. It's not just fishing around the edges. You can get good at skipping this thing under docks and giving those fish a topwater presentation right under that dock that I don't think they see a lot of. And for whatever reason, it does seem to generate a little bit bigger bite at times too, which is kind of cool. So something a little bit different, maybe a little bit situational, but if I'm looking to generate a little bit bigger bite and those fish are feeding up, topwater frog can be a really good option. And my setup for that, once again, 7-foot rod. It's actually the exact same rod that I throw the Texas rig on. 7-foot, medium heavy. It's got a little bit more of a limber tip, which allows me to skip this frog really well, but I throw it on braid. This is 40 pound Suffix 832 braid. You know, you don't need a real heavy frog rod to fish one around docks. Something a little bit limber with a little bit shorter length than what you maybe throw a frog when you're fishing a big mat or something like that. So give that frog a try. Something a little bit different look. and might just generate a little bit bigger bite for you. So those are my top five dock rods. Some of them are real standard. Some of them might be a little bit situational. What I'd tell you guys is get creative with it. You know, these might work for me. Give them a try, but don't be afraid to get creative with what you're throwing around docks. I think they see a lot of jigs. They see a lot of wacky rigs. You know, you can throw a number of different things around docks, and it can be really fun to try other things, especially your reaction type baits that I don't think they see a lot of. So, you know, dock fishing is a blast. Bass relate to it all over the country. It's super effective technique. Give these five a try, but don't be afraid to try some other stuff and get creative too. And you might just find that there's a bait out there that not many people are throwing around docks that can be super effective.